Third round, frustrating times for Chris Carmichael's in it.
Yeah.
I've just been listening to John Craig, you know, with his fighter on the steel, trying to pump him up. And this is what you got to do, you know, I know, I use your words, Vinny, you're a motivator. That's one of the caps that you wear as a trainer, isn't it?
Yeah.
And if you can't motivate your fighter, who the hell can? You know, you've got to give them wise words, you've got to give them motivational words, you've got
to
pump them up.
At the end of the day, though, son, it's up to them to listen. If you don't listen, it's not your fault.
Absolutely, you're right. You know, you can scream to your boy in the face, if they don't listen and don't move.
You can lead a horse to water, can't you?
Yeah.
Jay Woodham looks great.
He does. Like I said, he said that that's two rounds. Jay Woodham's on fire. It's his day, it looks like. You know, like I said, he's come off some losses, but against some absolutely extremely good fighters from the UK.
Yeah, and that's what's making him an extremely good fighter.
And that's what's brought him on, because if you lose to a good fighter, but yet you've been in with them, you can only get confidence from that, crikey.
Yeah, but he's not stopped doing it, has he?
No, it's not put him off, and it's obviously made him more determined.
It's the right hand that Jay Woodham's good at, like, see that, if he throws that.
This is like hunting him down but not following anything up, is he? Is he hunting without the weapons? Oh no. No, we've seen him, he's woken up. I don't know what's woke him up, Vinny, but something has.
He'll have a fight with you, will he?
We're now in for a fight, and this is what we wasn't having in the first two rounds. Was that just a little brief encounter, or is that shape of things to come in the rest of this fight?
That's the way the shape of things should have gone.
Yes. Conor getting very frustrated. You can hear him at the side of us here, Vinny, and I can understand why. I think if you and I would be doing certain the same things, just that I don't swear. But right. I'll be very close to
I'll
it.
I'll do yours.
Thank you. You can do my press-ups as well. No, I'll do the press-ups. You do the swearing.
Correct.
There's 50 press-ups in my gym for swearing. That's why there's probably a lot of fit people knocking about.
There's 50 press-ups in my gym for not swearing.
Hey! That means I'd be even fitter than what I am now. Let's come to your place.
Jay's out of range with the elbow, though. Just...
Corner's 10 seconds. Second out, round 4.
So round 4, we had a little taste of what Chris Carmichael was capable of, Vinny, but it was a very short blip in that little round. You know, again, motivational words from John Craig in the corner we were listening to there. You know, what else can you say to your fighter, Vinny?
So it's a very hard position to be in. Very, very hard position to be in that. Downs are too loose.
His mind is not on it, Vinny. It's his mind. That, I mean, you know, and I know, your mind controls your body. Your mind's not right, your body isn't right.
It's just not good enough, is he? You know what I mean? When the fights go on, if he's not good enough, he's not good enough,
the
is he?
The fight's not in him at all, is it? No, I mean, it happens, Vinny. It happens to a lot of fighters.
One fighter's going to be better than the other. Yes. Today, he is. That's Jay, right. Jay is. And don't forget, Jay's been on some really vicious... You know, losses, and look what he's doing. I've got to respect the kid.
Yeah.
I personally like him. He's a nice Kenny.
Well, he is. I mean, the thing is, if Jason is just picking his shots.
It's his tempo, and he's looking for it.
He's fighting clean, isn't he? He's had some absolute wars, hasn't he? He's probably thinking, right, I'm just going to go at my pace. I'm going to dictate the pace. I'm going to go up, do what I do. I'm going to pick the shots, do what I want to do, and I'm going to win this fight, or I'm going to win it. He's doing the right thing.
He's doing great.
You know, it'd be easy just to say, go ahead and finish Chris off because he's doing nothing. But at the end of the day, he's picking his shots. He's learning. He's probably a couple of fights where he's been stopped, and he probably wants to go the distance too. Yeah. A lot of fighters do, don't they?
Yeah, I think he's doing a great job. He's enjoying himself in that.
Yeah, he is.
He's enjoying it.
John's so frustrated with him. Say it. And I'd be exactly the same. He's hunting him down but doing nothing. Look, he moves lower in the ring, Chris, but then just doesn't do anything. Look.
Yeah, because every time he gets near, he gets kicked. Yeah, or every time he gets near, he gets push kicked.
Yeah, he gestures and doesn't do anything. And so Jay's just circling, moving round, and then picking him off.
Yeah, good kick.
Was that a body kick?
Yeah. That's the end.
Yeah, too relaxed, isn't he?
Finished.
Yeah, game over.
Yeah, good performance.
Yeah, and speaking on a personal level, Jason needed that. A good win for him. It's what he wanted, it's what he needed. Unfortunately, on this occasion, Chris Carmichael just didn't have the fight in him, and John was so frustrated with him.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner in the blue corner, Jason Norwood. And ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation, Mr. Chris Carmichael.